So, in the last class, we discussed about pre-coordinate indexing systems, right? So, still we are discussing, still we are in the same concept only, pre-coordinate indexing system techniques. So, in the last class, we saw what is chain indexing. So, continuing with that, we are going to discuss next topic, preserved context index system, that is PRECIS, PRECIS, that is the acronym of Preserved Context Indexing System. So we will see what PRECIS is, PRECIS index system is actually. Okay. So fine. So PRECIS is generally considered as one of the most ambitious late 20th century attempts to create an indexing system from the scratch. That means they formulated an indexing system right from the scratch, right from the start. Okay. Based on the, what do you say, based on the evolution of computers, the British National Bibliography shifted from manual to computerized, what do you call, to computerized bibliographical system. So as a result, chain indexing was replaced in the year 1950 by PRECIS. So PRECIS, in the sense, it does indexing system with the help of a computer. Chain indexing, which is done manually in the form of linking various chains together. PRECIS, where the indexer just gives the input strings and the computer performs the indexing. Okay. So PRECIS was developed by Derrick Austin actually. It is a system of subject indexing in which the initial string of items are organized according to a scheme of role operators. Okay. So these strings are organized according to certain scheme of role operators. So we will see what is role operators, what is the scheme of codes and various things associated with PRECIS indexing here. Okay. So this is the introduction about PRECIS. So what are the objectives actually? Here, see the first point, the computer, not the indexer, should produce all the index entries. That means the computer will produce the index entries, but what the indexer will do, his sole responsibility is to prepare the input strings and give necessary instructions to the computer to generate the index, right? So the indexer manually prepare the input strings only. Based on the input strings, the computer will generate index. So we will, in the example, we will see how the indexer manually prepares the input strings for a particular document. In the example part, we will see that. Okay. So each of the sought terms should find index entries, and each entry should express the complete thought content. See, in the chain indexing itself, I told you what is sought heading, right? The user, the heading, in which the user is likely to look for a particular document, that is sought. Okay. And the entries should represent complete thought content. Okay. So it is a surrogate. In the previous class, I told indexing is a surrogate. That means a substitute. It should exactly represent the content of the document, right? So entry should be prepared in such a way that what do you say, the index are representing the content of the document. So each of the entry should be expressive. It should be expressive, not limited, right? The system should be based on a single set of logical rules to make it consistent. So there is only a single set of rules. There is not a combination of several rules compiled together. Only a single set. The rules are like this. Step A is this. Second step is this. Third step is this. Fourth step is this. Only single step. Single set. There is no combination of other rules. No mixing and all. Right? The system should be based on the concept of open-ended vocabulary, which means that, what do you mean by open-ended vocabulary? That the terms can be admitted to the index at any time as soon as they have been encountered in the literature. So based on the reading of the literature, when you find a vocabulary, you can always include it in the index term. So that concept is called as open-ended vocabulary, right? The system must have sufficient references between semantically related terms. So the related terms are semantically interlinked with each other. So the system should provide references for the related terms, right? References for the related terms. So what are the features of PRECIS? It is more amenable to automatic manipulation than indexing based on the notational classification. That means here computer does the work, right? Most of, only the indexer manually does the input strings. So computer performs the indexing operations based on the input strings given by the manual indexer, by the indexer. Okay, so the automatic manipulation is enabled here, right? The permuted entries read naturally, which is achieved by the prescribed order of role operators. The role operators, we will see what role operators are in the forthcoming slides. The role operators give a prescribed order. So based on the order, the index, the entries are read manually. So process can be adapted to other languages. That is a possibility is that here you see the terms linked with machine held thesaurus, thereby providing possibilities to C and C also references. See, in the chain indexing entry, we discussed about preparing class index entry, and finally C also for the example Mughal, C Mughals, because there will be certain spelling differences and other differences. So C also and C references. Here the computer will help to prepare those kind of references. That is it. The indexer determines the meaning of the terms. So indexer manually does the meaning, determines the meaning of the terms, codes and the roles and identify the lead terms. Whereas the computer take care of the permutations. See, here the role is split up. Manually indexer does certain part and computer does certain part. What the indexer does manually? He determines the meaning of the term codes. So there are term codes for each, each content. So based on the term codes, he determines, so this comes in this code. So and identify the lead operators. We will see what is lead operator, qualifier operator and other. Okay, fine. So we've done display operator. So he identifies, and based on the identification of the lead terms, the computer will perform the indexing. Okay. Here the computer helps actually. Chain indexing is not like that. It is a subject formulation is completely independent of classification. Okay. Here in chain indexing, we know the classification number, right? Based on the classification class number only, we created a chain of class. Okay, then we prepared cross index entry. But this indexing system is independent of classification, right? Context is preserved. You must remember this. This is the concept of precis. Precis is context is preserved, right? It presents a full subject statement at every point of the index entry by gradual inversion of concept string, thus overcoming the problem of disappearing chain. See, it preserves each and every concept of the start content of the document. In the example, you will clearly understand what is context is preserved, right? It preserving the concept, the context of the subject based on index entries. So it will overcome the problem of disappearing chain. No chain here will disappear. Everything are preserved. Every concept here is preserved. So that is the, what do you say, concept of precis. Context is preserved, right? So the precis usually follows two important principles. One is principle of context dependency. That's what I told you earlier. It may seen as a combination of context as well as dependency. When this principle is followed in precis input string, each term is qualified and sets the next term into wider context. So it it takes some terms from the thought content of the subject and it qualifies each terms and moves it to the lead string, right? So that where the context of the document and thought content of the document is preserved. In other words, meaning of each term in the string depends upon the meaning of its preceding term and taken together. Preceding means coming next. Two comes after one. So two is preceding one in simple. Three comes after two. So three is preceding two. Preceding is coming after next. Okay. Meaning of its preceding term and taken together. Sorry, preceding is coming before. Okay. Preceding is before. Okay. Preceding is before, later is next. Okay. So hence, in the example, you will clearly understand. Hence, term is here dependent directly or indirectly on all the terms which precede it. Okay. So every term is interrelated or dependent to each other. Okay. That is the concept of this. So when you see the example, you will definitely understand. So what is one-to-one relationship? When the terms are organized to the principles of context dependency, so you are organizing terms based on the principle of context dependency, they form a one-to-one sequence, right? One after one, one-to-one related sequence, each of the terms in the string directly related to its next term. So every term in the string is having a relation between each other, right? So these are the syntax and semantic operations of prefixes. So the syntax of prefixes is based on the role operators. I will tell you what role operators is all about, and logical rules which acts as an instruction to the computer. Semantics is handled by the linking terms to a machine held thesaurus by providing C and C also. The semantics is done by the computer or the machine, right? It links with C and C also references. So role operator, what do you mean by role operator? It consists of a set of alphanumerical notations. Notations means symbols or code, which specifies the grammatical role of the function of the index terms and regulates the order of terms in the input string. Okay, so role operator nothing but it contains both alphabetical and numerical symbols which represents the grammatical role of the function, right, of the input terms to be indexed. So there are codes. Okay, there are role operator, there are two kinds of role operators: primary operators and secondary operators. Primary operators control the sequence of terms in the input string and determine the format of the entries. So the main role of primary operator is to determine the sequence, which should come first, which should come second, like that. It determines the sequence, right? And the secondary operator is preceded by the primary operator to which it relates. So after the completion of primary operator, then comes the secondary operator, right? Okay, fine. So use of codes in the string brings expressive in the resulting index. So codes, next is codes. So code is used to bring expressiveness. The thought content is to be expressed in such a way that the index wholly represents the subject matter. So codes are used for that. There are three types of codes: primary, secondary and typographic. So we will see what these are, right? And the third one is input string. A set of terms arranged according to the role operators. So we have identified the role operators and we have to arrange the role operator in accordingly. That is called as input string, which acts as an instruction to the computer for generating the index entries. So once you arrange the input string based on the role operators, you are telling the computer this: yes, I am ready, I have prepared my work, you go on and continue to make the index terms. So first you identify the role operator and then you see the codes to be expressed, the thought content, and then based on the role operator you are arranging into a sequence, right? That sequence is called as input string, and after the input string is done, the computer does the work for preparing the index of the document, right? So we will see how indexer formulates role operator and how it prepares the input string, right? So these are the role operators. That is, I have told you there are two kinds of operators: primary and secondary operator. So what is primary operator? So see, in primary operator is represented by numerical form only, 0 to 6. Secondary operator is represented in the form of alphabets. So when combining these two, they call it as alphanumeric, right? So see, these are the environment of core concepts. The core concept, the subject represents. Every subject represents its core concept, whatever title it may be. So this is the environment. The primary operator represents the environment of core concept of the subject, right? So 0 is for identifying the location, okay, location of the document or something, whatever it says. So 1 is key system. Key system, the thing when action is not present, or thing towards which an action is directed. A thing towards which an action is directed. When you see an example, you will understand what one represents. Two is effect of action or action. Three is performer of transitive action, like instrument, intake, whatever factors it may be. So four represents for viewpoint, from which viewpoint the subject discusses, something like that. And fifth is selected instant to study region, population, parameters, sample, and whatever the study took as a sample. So that will come in the, that will be represented as 5. And 6 is form of document, like target user, right? See, in chain indexing, we represented the chain using short link, unsort link, fast, false link, like that. Here we are representing the document using role operators, simple as that. Okay, so the concept is same, only the methodological perspective differs. Okay, here chain link, after the end of the chain we wrote FL, that is false link. This is short link, this is unsort link, and finally we took only the short link. Here instead of that, they are using these role operators, simple. So F is for coordinate concept, bound coordinate concept. G is for standard, and P is for part property, which property it refers to, which part it comes from, what is a part of that. So when you see an example, you will always understand what this G and because when I tell this theoretically, it will be vague to you. When I tell this role operators with a specific example towards the title, you will definitely understand this. So remember that there are two major role operators, primary and secondary. Primary is in the numerical form, secondary is in the alphabet form. So they are combined together as alphanumeric form. So these are the codes, okay? So don't confuse with the codes. Don't get too worried about the symbols and syntaxes, okay? So in the role operators, we saw that coordinate concept, property, part, everything. So Rogo asked the function of code is to express the thought content, nothing else. So role operators plays a vital role in determining the role of the document, whereas code is used to express it, nothing else. So no need to worry about it, okay? So now we are looking at the entry structure. I told you about lead, display and qualifier. So these are the entry structure. So entry structure of PRISIS consists of two D display rather than one dimensional. Okay. So instead of putting everything in one line, one dimensional is everything should be in one line. So instead of putting like that, the relationship is shown like this. Relationship is shown like a two dimensional from lead to lead, display and qualifier. So whatever the term which is appearing in the first, that will be the lead, okay? So whatever the term which is qualified to next appear in the lead, that comes under qualifier. So similarly, whatever term which is below, that will be in the display. So when you see the example, you will definitely understand. So lead is occupied by the approach term, which is filling word and offered as a user's access point in the index. So lead is the leading term. It is like a leader. You are leading a group of people. So group of class means you are the class leader. It is the first term. Simple as that. Qualifier is a position occupied by the term that sets the lead into a wider context, like general to specific. So together, the lead and qualifiers corresponds to the heading, right? So lead, qualifier. Qualifier is that sets the leads to a wider context. The qualifier next becomes the lead, okay? Like vice captain. So he is in line for the next lead. So similarly for index terms, after the lead, qualifier is next in line for the next lead, okay? So display the position occupied by the additional set of terms. So additional set of terms, there are also line. So like for example, you say captain, vice captain, backup vice captain, again backup vice captain. If captain is injured, vice captain will come. Again, vice captain is injured, backup captain will. So these terms are come in the display context, right? So when we see an example, you will definitely understand. See, these are the steps in PRISIS. So now I'm going to explain the process of PRISIS with an example, right? So take this title, okay? Title is University Libraries. This is step. Don't confuse this with role operator. Role operator 0 stands for location. Here you can ask why it is put as title. Okay, don't like ask like that. This is a step 0. Okay, not the role operator 0. Okay, here you see title. Title is University Libraries in West Bengal. So this is the document we got. As an indexer, what we have to do? We have to prepare the input string according to PRISIS format. That is our sole objective. So now we know the title. Like chain indexing, here we don't need class number, okay? Only base title, that is enough, okay? So second step, so that is the first step. What you will do? You need to do an analysis. In what kind of analysis? The analysis should involve the thought content of the document and formulating the subject statement in natural language. So you should analyze the document in such a way that it represents the thought content, okay? Here you see the title, University Libraries in West Bengal. What it says actually? Only University Libraries in West Bengal? Actually, it measures the performance of University Libraries in West Bengal. How the University Libraries in West Bengal are performing. So that is the thought content. So that is the analysis you have to do. Okay, that is the first step. After getting the title, you have to do an analysis based on the thought content. So when you read the document, you will understand what kind of study this document is carried out, right? Is carrying out. So here only the title is there. So based on the analysis, you find out that, oh, this study is measuring the performance of University Libraries in West Bengal. So after doing the analysis, you need to prepare the input string, okay? you need to prepare the input string. How do you prepare the input string? We already saw that we need to identify the role operator first. So based on the role operator, you need to arrange the role operator in a logical way. So then only input string will come. So for that, what you have to do? As I said, you need to identify the status of role operators of each component, denoting key concept in terms of role operator of process. Okay, as I told you, you should identify the role operator. Okay, so here you see the first subset of two, identifying the concept, signifying an action. Okay, identifying the concept, signifying an action. In the present example, the first step, you need to identify the concept which signifies any action. Is there any action? It represents any action. So in the example, we can see the action concept is denoted by the term measurement. So measurement is an action because it is measuring something, right? It is acting. It is an action. Okay. And in PEMS, we call it as an, what do you call, energy. Okay. So it is denoted by here. The action is first you need to identify. After analyzing, you need to identify the concept that representing an action. So here in this analysis, the keyword measurement represents an action. And this term should therefore prefixed by the role operator 2. So what is the role operator 2? You'll see it. See, action. Effect of action, you see. So since measurement is representing action, so we are fixing measurement role operator 2 for the action word measurement. Simple. So first job is done. So after identifying the kind of action represented, what transitive action intransitive action it's taking. So there is a measurement, right? But what it is measuring, you need to identify. So that is a transitive or intransitive action, right? So measurement is clearly a transitive action, definitely, because it is measuring something. Since it is capable of taking an object, it is definitely measuring something. So it is a transitive action, right? If it is not measuring, then it comes under intransitive. So you need to identify whether it is transitive or intransitive. So there is an action. Measurement is an action. But simply measurement does not fall, right? So it should be measuring something, at least measuring the research or measuring productivity or whatever it may be, right? So measurement is a clearly transitive because it is something it is doing. It is measuring something. So the object of transitive action is considered as a key system and is coded by the role operator 1, right? So what it is measuring, the object of transitive action is coded by the, it is a key component, it is coded by the role operator 1. So in the present example, what it is measuring the performance of the library. So performance is the role operator 1. So that is the transitive action, right? I hope so far you understand. So first, again, I will explain the steps in a nutshell again so that you can understand it better. So first we have the title. Okay, first we have only the title. As an indexer, we should prepare the input string according to PRISIS system, right? PRISIS technique. So like chain indexing, we don't need to have class number or call number. Okay, so we have the title. The first step, what we have to do is we need to analyze the thought content of the subject. So we have only this, University Libraries in West Bengal. So after going through the subject, you need, this is what this subject is talking about. That is the thought content. So this subject is talking about measurement of performance of the University Libraries in West Bengal. So you have analyzed the thought content and you have written it accordingly. So after analyzing the thought content, what we have to do? We have to prepare the input string. So how do we do that? For that, we need to identify the role operators. So for everything, there is a role operator, right? So first, for identifying the role operator, first we need to identify the concept of action. So whether this study is signifying any action or not. Here, measurement. In the title, there is no measurement. Only after thought content analysis you identify. Okay, so that is why this analysis is very much needed. Okay, so the measurement here is the action. So after identifying the action, we need to ensure that whether the action is transitive or intransitive. Here measurement is definitely transitive because it is definitely measuring something. It will definitely measuring something because the word measurement itself, it is going to analyze or measure something, right? Whatever it may be. So measurement is a transitive action. Okay, so what the measurement is actually measuring, right? Performance of the university. So performance become a transitive action. It is coded in the role operator 1. So you know what is role operator 1, right? That is a key system. thing towards which an action is directed. Here, performance measurement is directed towards performance. That is why it is represented as 1 in the role operator 1. So action is measure, action is what do you say? Action is a role operator 2, that is measurement. And what it is measuring, that is role operator 1, that is a key system which towards it is directed. So measurement is directed towards performance. I hope so far you understand. Okay. So after that, the sub-step, next sub-step is you have identified the action. And you have identified the transitive action, and now you identify the concept if any related as property or whole to part, whether the concept is related to any property or any whole or to any part. Okay, whether the concept is related to any property, we will see what property, or any part or something like that. So in the example, performance is the property of university library, because what is the performance you are measuring? Not a student's mark or something. Here the title is clearly says that university libraries in West Bengal, measuring the performance of university libraries. So as a result, performance becomes a property of university library, and libraries are part of university. So now you understood the concept of property and part, right? So performance is a property of university libraries. So because here the subject is measuring the performance of university libraries, and we all know libraries is definitely a part of university. Okay, library is a part of university. So you see universities, libraries. So here one is university, one role operator is for university, and P role operator P operator is for role operators for library and performance. We know one is university because we know what is role operator one, right? That towards which an transitive action is stationed, or towards which an transitive action is taken, right? So performance is done towards university. So university becomes one here, okay? So these P and P are sub operators. We saw in the role operators, secondary operators. Secondary operator precedes after the, comes after the primary operators. So I'll take you back here. You see P, part and property. So that is why that role operator is denoted as P. So performance is a property of university library, and library is a part of university. So for part and property, only one role operator, that is secondary operator P. So primary operator 1 represents university. The secondary operator represents the parts and property of that university, that is library and performance. Okay, I hope you understood so far. So second is measurement. We already know 2 is measurement. So that is action, right? So the remaining term is West Bengal only. So what is remaining in the title? Only West Bengal. We all know location. For location, the operator is 0, right? We all know that. We saw it. See here, location is operator is 0. So automatically, according to the operator 0 is to be prefixed to the concept of resulting input string. See 0, 1 and part and property, and 2 measurement. So this is the order, right? So now we have prepared the input string. So now I hope you understood this procedure so far, right? This is the method of preparing the input string using precise index system, right? So before for that, you need to, this is a note to give you some highlights, right? The primary operators have ordinal filling values. The term in the above input strings are sequenced accordingly. So the input strings are sequenced accordingly. Okay, thus component terms are organized into above input strings according to the principles of context dependency. See, the terms of the component are organized in such a way it ensures the principles of context. The context of the thought content of the documents is preserved, right? The here you see, here in the title, you see only university libraries in West Bengal. Based on the analysis only, we got measurement and performance. So that is the thought content. We are preserving the thought content here. The input strings includes performance, right? And measurements, that is not in the title. So here the thought content is preserved. So this is called as context. This is called as context dependency. Okay, this is called as context dependency. So this is the principle of context dependency. Okay, preserving the thought content of the document. You see, the primary P prefixed with libraries denoting the part of the university is preceded by the primary optator one to which it is related. So because the library is related to universities, right? So that is the part of university. Performance is a property of university, right? Because it is measuring the performance of the university only. So performance is ultimately the property of the university. But library is a part, not a property. Okay. So you should understand the difference between part and property. So the secondary operator P is fixed. We know what P is, right? P denotes both part as well as property. And also property of the libraries is preceded by the secondary operator P, meant for libraries. These terms except proper name West Bengal are written. See, these are the conditions. That is a code. That is why the code is needed, right? See, except the proper name West Bengal, others are written in lower case initials. So index entries will be generated in upper case initial by the computer. Okay. So you tick mark is also to be provided for the terms which should appear as lead. So we will see what lead, qualifier and display is. Okay. See here, except West Bengal, everything is written in lower case. So that is one of the criteria, okay? But the index, in the index, the computer will prepare it as uppercase, okay? So these are the steps. Now we are going to come to the steps in preparing index entries. We have done the input strings, right? We have done the input strings. Now we have to prepare the lead, qualifier and display. The first index entry will be generated by the computer by pushing the first term of the input string, right? So this work is done by the computer actually, but I am explaining how it does it actually, okay? The first index entry will be generated by the computer by pushing the first term of the input string into the lead position. Here you see what is the first term of the input string. Till this part, we manually prepare the index. So till this part, we manually prepare the index. After this, the computer will take over for preparing the index term. So here you see the first part, West Bengal. So the computer will take the first part, first entry, and it will push it into the lead. So here you see West Bengal is in lead, right? West Bengal is in lead position. So rest, the rest, universities, libraries, performance, measurements, all are in display position. All are in display position. You see? See, this here the West Bengal is lead and other terms are in display. So I will tell you what qualifier is all about. Okay. So first we have the first input string as a lead. So we prepared West Bengal as a first input string. So that will be in the lead. So other input strings are in the display position, like universities, libraries, performance measurement, everything in the display position. Okay, see. Universities, libraries, performance, measurement, everything in the display position. Now, the second index entry will be generated by pushing the second term of the input string into the lead position. That means, what is the second term here? Universities. So, university will go to the lead position. West Bengal will move to the qualifier position. And the other words, other key input strings will remain in the display position. Now, I hope you understood the concept of lead, qualifier and display. In the first thing, only first input string will be in the lead position. There is no qualifier position. All the others are in the display. When the second input string goes into the lead position, the first input string becomes a qualifier position. Here in this example, see, university is in the lead position. West Bengal is in the qualifier position. Other three are in the display position. In the first step, only lead position is there. West Bengal is in the lead position. No qualifier position is there. And all are in display. Here you see, universities has taken over as the lead. So now vice captain has become the captain. And the captain has become the vice captain. That is the qualifier position. And others are players like display. Okay. Similarly, for each input string, the lead position and the qualifier position will change. Here in the third, you see, libraries has taken over as lead position, universities and West Bengal has become qualifiers and other becomes display. Okay. So finally, there will be one sequence of fly-in, right? So after preparing this index entries, so C and C also reference entries will also be prepared by computer. because manually in class index entries, in chain indexing, we did that manually, right? Here the machine will take care of everything. Alphabetization, all the entries generated by the process are arranged alphabetically. Everything will be arranged alphabetically under by headings. Okay, fine. So all the displays and all the displays are arranged alphabetically. Now you see, everything has become a display here, right? There is no, what do you call, lead and qualifier. I hope you understand the steps in process. Okay, this is how the manually an indexer prepares an input string, and after the input string, the computer. This part is done by the computer, okay? But you need to learn how the computer does it. If you give the input string wrong, the index will be wrong. So whatever the person indexer feeds into the computer in the input string, the computer will prepare index. Simple. If the input string, your preparation of input string is wrong, and everything will collapse, right? So there are two format. There are different formats and presses. Actually, you will see that standard format. So what we discussed so far is a standard format. That means index entries are generated with primary operators 0, 1 and 2. Here you see, here 0, 1 and 2. So if the index entries are generated with these three role operators, it is called as standard format. So our example is also a standard format. So this is also one example only. Training labors in India. Okay. So India is a location, it comes in 0. So labor is the action, and training is the action, and labor is which the action is directed towards. Okay. So that is one. So if based on this 0, 1 and 2, if the input strings are generated, it is called a standard. But there are other role operators like 4, 5, 6, right? Like 4, 5, 6, we didn't see that, right? See here. View pointer, form of document, selected instance, study region. These are other operators, right? 4, 5, 6. We saw only 0, 1, 2. So if the index entries are generated, if the index entries are generated in the range from 4 to 6, or its dependent appear in the lead, then we can say it is an inverted format. Okay, then we can say it is that is an inverted format, not a standard format. Okay, a report on the feminist from the viewpoint of marriage. Here you see report 6 is because 6 represent type of document. Type of document is a report, right? So 4 we saw 4 represents viewpoint. So it talks about feminist viewpoint. So 2 is marriage. Okay, it is 2 is an action. So when the here you see the 6 becomes the lead here. In the third you see this is the lead. So when from 4 to 6 or its element becomes a lead, automatically it is called as inverted format of process, right? So one more format is there, a predictive transformation. Entry is generated under term coded that immediately follows a term coded by either 2 or S or T. Okay. Here you see everything is there is no secondary codes here. There is no secondary codes here. 1, next is 2, next is T. Okay. By this is the code, by $V or $W. That means upward and downward direction. In the secondary operator, we will see that. Okay, I'll show you. Here you see this. Upward reading connective. Okay, that it connects directly downwards and upwards. So when such kind of system is followed, 1, 2, 3, that is called as predictive transformation. So this is all about how to prepare input strings based on precise method of indexing. So this is the references. Please go through this to get a exhaustive overview about the precise indexing system. So, thank you.